Hi everyone, welcome to the session on Python basics. In this session, I will cover the parameters in depth in the Python function. So the moment when if we want to print something, we will say print and we'll say the print keyword, and then we'll use a double quotes or a single quote, and then we'll execute and we'll get a print in our console. Instead of single quote, you can use a double quote also and execute this. So you can see it will work with both the single quote and double quote. Now the most important thing of this session is the parameters which I'll discuss in depth. And also if you can see here, these two parameters, 4 and 5, is the most important, the USP of this session. So I will show you, okay, how it works. So let's see. So whatever we print inside this, it is nothing but an object. And then separators are like the separator between multiple object that needs to be printed. So how separator works? So I'll say escape below and say print welcome. Then I'll say to. If I print this separator, the default value, I don't know the default value. Okay, so these are the default value for separator. It will be spaces. So if I execute this, I'll say welcome to technological. If I want to change this default value, okay, I'll come here, I'll paste here, and then I'll say separator is equal to, I'll say, okay, semicolon. Then if you see welcome to technological, even in case of if you don't want this semicolon, you want something, you don't want any separator, okay, you just want them to then don't give anything, just pass like value like this, and you see welcome to everything is being merged basically. Okay, now after the separator, we have the something called end value. And before this, if you want to, like I have pasted here, okay, I've worked my, done my research, I've pasted. If you don't know how to get the default value or how to, if you want to get the details about this print function, just take your cursor here and press shift tab. And again, press shift tab, you get all the details. And again, so it will go, okay. You can see here all the default values for separator is equal to spaces or end parameter slash n. If I take this value here and I print it and I am not getting giving anything, okay. Okay, now if I say I will remove the value of separator, I'll say separator is default, which is spaces, and I'll say, or if I don't even say end is equal to slash n, okay, even if I remove end is equal to slash n because a default value, still my output will be welcome to technological. It will not be printed in the different line, because if only if there is multiple print statement like this, only like this, okay. Now if you see what will happen, welcome to technological will print in the first line, and the after this slash n will be there, and then it will, this Python basics will print in the second line. Now what you do here end parameter, I will give something like this, some spaces, okay. Now what will happen here, you see welcome to technological and Python basics are being merged with a space in between them, okay. So now let's dive more into this end parameter with the perspective of the Python escape characters or escape sequence and see how it will work, okay. So I'll say print hello world, and I'll say end is equals to spaces, and then I'll say print my life, my tools, just like this, okay. And then I'll say nothing. In this case, these two string will be merged, okay. This is very simple, I've already explained here. Now after this, what I will do, instead of end is equals to spaces, what I will say, I'll say end is equals to slash t. Slash t means slash tab. Now if I execute this, see after hello world there is this much of space, right? This is nothing but 8 bytes characters will come. After this, what I will do, instead of slash t, I'll take some other characters, I'll say slash r, okay. If I say slash r, then what will be my output? See, slash r means it will print hello world, it will after, and the hello world will be overwritten by my life, my rules. That's why it is coming like this. Okay. Now, if you are working with some directories or anything, in that case, you can say print c colon comma end is equals to double slash, and then you can again say print users comma end is equals to again double slash. Execute this. We can see c colon backslash users. Okay, now in case of forward slash, if you want to use, how you will print forward slash. Okay, now I want to also see what is backspace. Okay, so I will take this, copy this, and instead of back slash I, I'll say slash b. So slash b, what it will do, so you can see here, hello w or l, the last character will be replaced by my life, my rules. Okay, now what I will do, I will replace this by two backslashes, and if in doing so, this ld will be replaced by my life, my rules. So slash b, and again I'll give slash b. Execute this. So you can see hello world, my life, my rules. Okay, so I believe like I'm able to make you understand about this end parameters. So with some of this Python scape characters, it's making more sense how to use the end parameters. After that, what I will do, we will dive into the separate parameters. So if I say print hello, okay, now and then if I say separator is equals to hash, okay, now this separator will work within the same print parameter. It will not work with the other print parameters. Okay, so out of this five parameters, if you see, I have covered object, separator, and end. Now the most important, the file and the flush. So file, what we will do, see, this is nothing but the console where it is being printed, right? Now I don't want to write my output, I don't want to display it here in the console. I want to write into my file somewhere. So how that will work, so what I'll say, suppose source file is equals to, I'll open and then say something python dot, I'll say source file is equal to open python.txt, and then I'll say comma, I want to write, okay, and here I'll say print and then here I'll say file is equals to this source file and then dot, because we have opened it here, and then after it will write it, this welcome to this object in my file, it should be closed. Okay, so let's execute this. What is my current working directory? Pwd python basics. Okay, and if you see here, I'll say date modified. Okay, so you can see Python text is here, and you can see here file welcome to technology cult. So this is also done. Only the parameter that is left is the now. Flush parameter is a bit tricky. You won't get the output of the flush parameter so easily. Okay, so now we are left with our last parameter, the flush. Flush the stream explicitly if it is set to true. So it means like if we are printing here, okay, something for I in range 10, and we will say print I. So if you can say, because this is default to true, everything will be displayed at once. Instead of this, if you say for I in range of 10, okay, we'll say print I comma flush is equal to false. Here also it is showing the same display, but how do we know which one is correct? So the issue here is flush parameter will not work in the so we'll say import from time import sleep. Okay, and then what we'll say, we'll run a simple for loop for I in range of 10, and then for I in range of 10, and then we'll say print I comma end is equals to, we'll say space, and initially we'll say flush is equals to true, which is by default, so let it be, and we'll say sleep 0.5. okay, now see what is how the value will be displayed. value is getting displayed after every 0.5 seconds. Okay. Similarly, in case of flush is equal to 4. What will happen? Okay. Everything is being displayed at once, and here it has displayed step by step. Okay. So I believe I am able to make you understand the concept, because in Jupyter and Spider it was not working, and then I find out somehow that it is working in the demo is working in shell. Okay. Command prompt shell. Python shell. So that's it for the session. And in this session, what we have learned, okay, we have learned about the print and the print parameters, different parameters, and also the default value and how we can play with them. Okay, so thanks a lot for watching the session. If you feel this video is helpful, please press the like button and subscribe to this channel. And I'll see you in my next video, where I'll show you how to work with the Python progress bar. Okay. So I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.